you heard of a bug hotel?
Yes.
How would you explain it?
Sticks and leaves in some wood or an enclosed area, and so they can go in and live.
Exactly. And basically what they do is find a nice confined space, because they want something tight, and then they lay their eggs in there. And then the babies will hatch and they'll fly off, because most of our native bee species are loners. So they live on their own. They don't live in a pack. So something like this, and this is really easy. Like, this is what I like about doing a project like this is everyone's got an old tin can at home. Now, for this bug hotel, I just put old Banksia cones in there, because, you know, an insect could find that that's useful. But what I've done here is actually use bamboo, okay? And you just have to drill or push out the center where there might be pith in the bamboo, so that it's at least about a centimeter deep, and that's what they need. And then the bees will come and lay their eggs in there. And the really cool thing about it is when the hotel has some rooms that are booked out, you'll see that it's covered over, and it's kind of like a little bit of reflection. It might be clear, sort of. Others fill it up with sand or clay. And when the holes are full, you know that there's someone using the room, which is really, that's what makes it exciting, because you could put it in a tree like that, simple as that. There we go. And then you can look and see, oh, look, one's covered over, one's covered over. And then you'll see at some point, if you watch it, you might see the bee coming out. Do you reckon you could have a go at making this with me?
Yeah.
So let's take the cones out of this one. And what you have to do is pack these into there. And then once it's full, I'll just take one of these just to make sure I've got our length. And you can cut some as well if you like. How many more do you think we need? Mm. Oh, quite a few. Do you want to cut some? All you have to do is just make a template of one that you say, yeah, that's long enough. So I made them to just the length of the rim, and then just do that. And you can use even a pair of nice sharp secateurs will do it. And see, that hole's already good. Yeah, that's nice, because if you just use the tip of the secateurs, you don't crush it. It just cuts it. So you only need to go in about a centimetre. Okay, if you go a little bit further, that's all right. But they like it tight. They like it nice and cosy. They don't want a big long hole coming right out the other end, because then it's not a feeling of safety in.
How long do they stay in the bee hotels?
They stay in the bee hotels anywhere from a couple of weeks to a month. Generally speaking, you'll get bees come in here, but sometimes you might find that spiders will build their webs across here, because they're thinking, okay, I'm going to stand outside the fly through because something could come and I can catch them. So from time to time, you might want to dust.
So are the bees just going to come because you make this?
Well, yes and no. It's good to have it here because we need more homes for the bees. But I think you need to do this alongside putting in more flowering plants and thinking about what are the flowering plants that our native bees like, and starting to plant some native species so that will bring them to the flowers, and then you'll have a hotel, because they'll say, hey, I want to hang in Amelie's garden because there's so much food here, I better book a room and put some eggs down and have children. I'd like to stay here. And so that's how we can do it. It's a two-way thing. We've got to have the flowering plants, and then have the habitat. And that way, you'll start to see these blocked over and you'll be like, visitors, visitors.